What you're about to see now is one of the most remarkable farm projects that I've worked on in recent time. Built on over 1,540 square meters of land in the city of Mowe, Ibafo, here in Ogun State, Nigeria. Now, imagine standing in the BSF facility with over 4,000 BSF crates, producing up to 18,000 kilograms of black soldierfly larvae every single month. And not just that, with advanced machineries for production and processing of the larvae, and a fish unit, a feed unit that can power up to 20,000 capacity fish farm, and one of the largest Azolla farms in the country, spanning over 2 acres of land. This is not just a farm, this is a vision of the future, and today I'm taking you in. Welcome to Flourish Consolidated Farms Limited. Now, this is our hatchery room. Now, every successful BSF farm must have a place where they put aside for hatchery, because without that, you're going to run into a lot of challenges. Now, in this crate, I have 2 grams of neonate. Take note, I didn't say 2 grams of egg, 2 grams of neonate, because with the amount of neonate I collect, I can be able to give an estimate of the amount of larvae that I will get in a month. Now, so this crate has 2 grams of neonate, and 1 gram of neonate can give us 3 kg or 3.5 kg of BSF eggs. So it's safe to say that 0.5 grams of neonate can give us around 1.5 kg to 2 kilograms. Right now at Flourish Consolidated Farm, we're already getting around 2 kilograms out of 3 months. This is our waste processing unit with drums. We have other drums elsewhere that we are using to process our waste. Now, for new intending BSF farmers, one of the major challenges that you may encounter when you are doing BSF farming is waste management, or where to get waste, organic waste, to feed the larvae. Now, in Nigeria, in Lagos State, Nigeria, tons of waste are dumped into the landfill every day. We don't have a system that helps to manage those waste. That's why it's difficult to get waste from the marketplace to use to raise the larvae. And that's why you must have proper plan in place before you venture into BSF larvae farming. Now, we have every single day in this farm, we use around 2.4 tons of waste to feed our larvae. And we have to get that every single day in order for us to meet up with the amount of larvae that we're going to get in a month. The 2 insectariums that we have here. Now, every insectarium has its own advantage and disadvantages, right? So we have this massive insectarium, and then we have the love net section, right? This we do in order for us to get the required amount of eggs that we need to produce the 18,000 kilograms of larvae every single month. Now, in this insectarium, there are several modalities we have put in place. We have introduced artificial lighting, we have introduced spraying machine, amongst other things, to ensure that the supply of egg is consistent irrespective of the weather condition of the place. Now, these flies are all over me. They don't carry any form of diseases. They are pathogen free. And that's the reason why BSF, black soldier fly larvae, is one of the safest insects to cultivate and produce your larvae. Unlike the house fly, if the house fly are all over you like this, you're sure to fall sick, because they carry a lot of diseases. The house fly, they feed. These ones, they don't feed, they only drink water, and they take water to survive for the number of days they're supposed to live, and then they produce the eggs that you need, and you are good to go. So this is the insectarium. I'll take you to the love net section. Hi, my name is Mack Diasa. I am here again with Flourish Consolidated Farms. As you can see what I'm holding, these are BSF FRAs, which are very powerful organic fertilizer. As it is now, we cannot use them to plant, whether you're into tomato or pepper or bell pepper farming, whatever crop farming you're into. We can't use these FRAs to plant as it is. So here at Flourish Consolidated Farm, we normally send these our FRAs to another of our facility where we allow them to cure, we treat them, we add some other organic materials to it to make it very suitable for your crops. Okay, so here we have up to 30 tons production capacity every month. We have enough fras for everybody. So if you need fras, give us a call, right? Send us a message from the number you're seeing on your screen, and we'll supply you the best fras. You shouldn't be using poultry waste as your manure. It's not as good as this BSF fras. And the beautiful part of this is that our fras are very, very affordable. Very affordable, and you're going to get the value of the money for that you're using to buy the fras. And now, if you've not subscribed to this channel, please subscribe to this channel, because very soon we want to make a video document using these BSF fras and then using commercial fertilizer side by side. Let's see the one that will do better. I already know the answer or the result of that experiment, but we want to make that video to cure some of the people, some of our viewers' curiosity or their doubt. So we're going to make that video so you see the difference between using our fras or our organic fertilizer and then using the commercial fertilizer. All right, so if you're not subscribed, please subscribe to this channel so that when we make that video and post, you will see the video. So thank you very much. So we're taking it to our curing facility, and now to the fishery section. So this is a massive fish farm that can power 20,000 grow-out fishes. Now each of these ponds, as you can see, is about 20 by 20 feet wide and about 4 feet deep. And this farm has the state-of-the-art hatchery unit with a treatment plant that can produce a lot of fingerlings. So if you need fingerlings, I think you can give Flourish Consolidated Farm a call to get your high quality fingerlings. It's one of the largest Azolla facilities that we have here in Nigeria. Now, this facility we built for Flourish Consolidated Farm can produce up to 1.5 tons of Azolla every single day. Now, each of this pond is measuring 40 feet long and 7 feet wide. And fish farmers, poultry farmers, whether you are a layer bed farmer or you are a boiler farmer or any whatever livestock farming that you're into, Azolla farming is what you should incorporate into your business. Now let me take you in so you see some of the ponds that are ready and the ones that are still under construction. By the time we're done, we'll have over 130 pieces of these Azolla ponds right here. So for those of you that are wondering what is Azolla, or those of you that are just hearing of Azolla for the first time, now Azolla is actually an aquatic thing. It grows on shallow water bodies and it is very, very rich in protein. You can get up to 20 to 30% crude protein from Azolla, amongst other things like the amino acid profile. And that's why each farm should incorporate Azolla diet into their feed for their livestock. Now imagine this farm's ability to be able to produce up to 1.5 tons of Azolla every day. That means that they have a lot of feed for their livestock. Now if you are into poultry farming, like you have layer beds, Azolla is something that you should incorporate into their diet. You will see improved egg productivity amongst other things. See, you don't have to take my word for it. Just do your own research and you'll be amazed at the enormous benefit that Azolla has to offer to your livestock. Now, we are offering training on how to farm black superfly larvae as well as Azolla farming in one course. See, don't miss out on that training. We have a wonderful platform, farmbsf.com, and we have the mobile application both for Android and iOS on the Play Store and Apple Store. You can go there, download the app, pay the fees, go through the training, and we have 24/7 support for you. You have questions, you can give us a call, you can, you know, send us a message on our platform, and we'll be happy to respond to you. See, your farm should not close down. No, not with information that are valuable, not with this insight that are valuable at your fingertips. You shouldn't close down your farm because of inability to feed your livestock or because of low profit. With Azolla, you can cut down the cost of your feeding by many percentage. Just try this and you'll come and thank me later. Now, if you have watched this video to this point, thank you so much. And if you've not liked or subscribed, please, I appreciate you for you to like this video, subscribe, share to your friends, share to other farmers that are struggling. They really need this information. Your farm does not have to close down because of the challenges with feed, amongst other things. And I want to do a special thanks to my team members who've been here for 3 months working on these different projects. And thank you for all the work that you've done. I want to say a big thank you to the client that brought us here and for all the things that he has done for us. Thank